Hi, in this video I would like to show you something, but not this thick station breadboard power supply, which is very useful. It can produce plus minus 12 volts, plus 5, plus 3.3 and one adjustable, but an oscilloscope. As you know, I have several desktop oscilloscopes, but I'm also interested in small handheld oscilloscopes. That was my first oscilloscope. It is basically a toy because the AD conversion is taken on this device by the microcontroller AD converter. But because this converter is more than 8-bit, it is a higher resolution oscilloscope, but the frequency range is very limited. And the handling is not so easy because so many buttons and switches are there. The same capability is built into this shell. It is called the shell oscilloscope. And you can set what do you want to set, time per division or voltage per division or trigger level. And with this adjusting button, you can easily set what you want. But both of them are only single channels oscilloscope, so you cannot compare two signal. And I also bought this big one. It is a two channel and plus one generator Hentec oscilloscope up to 80 megahertz. This is another one. It's made by, I don't know, Tooltop or something like this. Why it is not mentioned on this? So it is also a two channel and plus one generator, but that is the two end of the scale. And now we shall deal with this. It's arrived in a bag, of course, and in the bag that was this black box. It's black box, and the label is absolutely doesn't contain any type or any addition, if only made in China. That is the only usable part of this. Now, if you open it, inside you will find a bilingual manual. Of course, the half part is Chinese, and then in English you can see the buttons, how can you use, short press, long press, and so on. How can you use it as an oscilloscope in time domain? Lissajous interface, a little funnily spelled. It's a French name, maybe that's the cause of it. And how can you measure current? And how can you update the firmware? Because this oscilloscope has a unique feature. Here is the oscilloscope. And it is a two inputs oscilloscope. It's nice because you can compare two signal, or also you can produce Lissajous feature. And it has this two metal point where you can measure current with this oscilloscope. And you can buy it in three set. I bought the cheapest set because I'm only curious how this oscilloscope is working. I have a lot of scope probe, so I got two alligator clip, a BNC cable, and one USB-C charging cable. And if you pay more, you can get one real scope probe instead of one alligator cable. And if you pay more money, then you got two real scope probe. Now, let's see it. Here it has a very easy form factor. It's like a box, a little rounded on the corners, and it's very easily you can put on the table, and you can see it as a sheet of paper, for example. Now let's turn it on, and with this you can see how fast is booting. So first it says something, it's what is the time, then warning you high voltage is dangerous or something similar. I cannot read it because it's so shortly showed on the screen. From the video I will read it later. And now here is the oscilloscope itself. It has several buttons. If you press the menu button long time, then you can choose between the real oscilloscope mode with the left and right key, with the XY mode, the current measurement, and one extended function. Here you can later, as the factory promised, upgrade the firmware in this device. So go back to the oscilloscope. And if you press OK, here is the oscilloscope. If you press it shortly, then another menu, a pop-up menu, can be visible. Here you can see what do you want, do you want to roll or not, how many channels do you want to use, one, channel one, channel two, or both of them, and so on. Do you want a cursor, do you want a compress, and what do you want to measure, voltage, maximum, minimum, peak, RMS and average, so on, or frequency, period, duty cycle, plus, duty cycle, minus, and pulse width, and so on. And here you can see what background do you want, an empty one, or line, or scale, which language, of course English is our favorite language from the possible two, the brightness, auto standby, I turn it off, a computer off, and save wave on, so you can store waveforms. And let's see the last one. And it's explained the feature. The sampling rate is 50 megasample per second. And that's mean it is able to produce a 10 megahertz analog bandwidth. Storage depth is 10 kilobit or 10 kilo sample, I'm saying. Measuring range is plus minus 400 volt. Couple mode AC-DC, resolution 300 by 200, input resistance 1 megohm, and software version. It's not so old, it is from last year, July. No. Anything else? No. It's round back. So, press the menu button, and here is the oscilloscope. And without any signal, it is very difficult to study an oscilloscope. So, where is my BNC cable? Here is a BNC cable. I put it onto the channel 1. And now, I will use this small generator, because it is easy to put it into the array of the camera. That is channel 1. It's a Unity, one of my favorite small generator, because it is able to work from any 5 volt DC, so you can use it on the field with a power bank. Let's turn it on. And no. Channel 1 is off. Let's turn it on. And now you can see it's a 1 megahertz square wave at the beginning. And it looks nice on this small oscilloscope. Let's see how can we set it. So if you press the left and right arrow, for example right, now it is in the vertical position, the blue. Now you can set the voltage per division, for example 2 volts, 1 volts, half volts. And the next is the probe, 1x or 10x, and the following is the time per division. Unfortunately, that is the smallest value, 100 nanosecond. And here you can see the next, is it a DC or AC coupled? The next is which age is used for triggering, falling age or rising age. Now you can say it is moving. And of course you can stop it with the hold button. And now if I remove the signal, it is still on the screen as normal on a digital oscilloscope, but I put it back. So, and the frequency is 1 megahertz. What else can we measure? For example, let's measure VPP is already set. Where are the measurements? Yes, I remember I have seen a YouTube video where someone explained that if it is in the fastest time division, then sometimes the measurements are missing. Let's check it. Yeah, here is the VPP measurement. And if it is in 250 nanosec or 100 nanosec, it is disappears. Okay. Well, maybe it's normal. But now let's see the frequency response of this device. So that is the fastest mode, 100 nanosecond, and try to increase the frequency of this signal. 1 megahertz, 2 megahertz, 3 megahertz, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So of course it is not normal to use a 10 megahertz square wave on a 10 megahertz bandwidth oscilloscope, but try it with sine wave, for example. So that is the sine wave, and if we increase the frequency, 1 megahertz, 2, 3, 4, 5, so the amplitude is nearly the same, and at 6, 7 megahertz, about the 3 dB point of this device. So, for low frequency measurements, this device is very capable to use. What else can we see? Let's use another signal, channel 2, and put it onto the oscilloscope. I check the picture. Yes. Two channel, channel 1, change channel 2, shortly press this, yes, frequency 2 megahertz for example, yes. And if I set it 1 megahertz, the two signal is the same, the amplitude is different, and the phase is just now 180 degrees, so it means that the opposite. Okay, let's set it to 90, and long press, and right, okay, and here you can see the Lissajous picture, which is a circle, but because the two signal amplitude is very different, that's why it is not a real circle, it's a ellipsoid, and of course you can set different phase, see? But it's interesting, the 180 degrees is as a zero on a normal standard oscilloscope, and the zero is like a opposite on any other oscilloscope. Maybe if you see it in this direction, then it will be the real mode. This is not the first oscilloscope what I have seen between small size oscilloscope which use wrong phase on the Lissajous screen. So this is a 1 kHz 1 volt peak to peak signal. It said nearly 1 volt and 1 kHz. And let's set it to like that. So that is the sine wave. You can see that that is the total amount of samples, and in the middle only one sign is visible. But if you press the button, for example, this, and this, now you can move it, the trigger point, left and right. And on the top you can see where is the sample in the full amount of samples. It's best place in the middle. You can also set the trigger level. Here you can see if it is above the signal will be running. And now it is, if it is below, it is also a problem. But in the middle, it is a good choice. So, and you can change the trigger age. Notice the rising age, that is the falling age in the middle of the oscilloscope. It is in 1x mode because it's a direct BNC cable connected to the generator and it says 1 volt, but if you set it to 10x, then it shows 10 times higher voltage, in our case about 10 volts. And you can set the signal smaller or bigger. And here you can move the signal up and down. So, as an oscilloscope, you can use it very easily. Now in the following part of this video, let's see the current measurement. Now it is set it to half amp, and if I turn on, one division is half amp, turn on the power supply, one division is higher. Let's set it to 1 amp, 1.5, 2, 2.5, 3 amps. Now turn it off. So now set it to 1 amp per division, and that is 3, 4, 5, and 6. This is a programmable power supply. I set it to produce 1 amp for 1 second and 5 amps for 1 second. And let's see it on this small device. One division is a half second, so the signal is 2 division, which is equal 1 second, 2 amps, and the same time is 5 amps. If I turn it off, then it is the 0. Now I turn back again. So you can measure current easily with this small oscilloscope, but mostly DC current as it is mentioned in the manual. So this is the QR code on the back of the manual. Maybe you can use it from the screen. And I'm saying that was enough about this small dual channel 10 MHz bandwidth oscilloscope. I hope that it was useful for more of you. And if it is so, please thumbs up. Press the like button, and if you're interested in similar technical videos, then you can subscribe to my channel. Please do it if you haven't done it yet, and in that case, you will be notified if I produce a new video on YouTube. And thank you for watching this small video. Have a nice day, and goodbye.